Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. The story of Sulaiman alayhi salatu wa salam. The Prophet Sulaiman alayhi salatu wa salam was born and raised in Jerusalem, Palestine. He was the son of Prophet Dawood alayhi salam, and just like his father, Sulaiman alayhi salam was greatly loved by Allah. Allah gifted Sulaiman alayhi salam with miracles that no other prophet had. Sulaiman alayhi salam could understand and communicate with all kinds of animals. He could command the wind. The jinn are unseen beings created by Allah, and Sulaiman alayhi salam was given the power to command them too. One time Sulaiman alayhi salam was marching through a valley with his magnificent army of jinn, men and birds. The army came to a valley which happened to be the home of ants. Seeing this great army, one ant said to the others, "Hide in your homes before Sulaiman alayhi salam and his army crush you under their feet." Sulaiman alayhi salam understood what the ant had said. He smiled to himself and thanked Allah for all the special gifts he had been given. Sulaiman alayhi salam achieved amazing feats during his lifetime. The Quran tells many stories of Sulaiman alayhi salam and his amazing achievements. One of the most beloved things to Sulaiman alayhi salam was Masjid al-Aqsa. Masjid al-Aqsa was first built by Adam alayhi salam. After hundreds of years, it was rebuilt by Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam. After many generations, it again fell to ruins. When Prophet Dawood alayhi salam became king of Jerusalem, he began to rebuild the masjid, but he died before it was completed. Sulaiman alayhi salam and his army of helpers continued Dawood alayhi salam's work and finished rebuilding the blessed masjid. While he was rebuilding Masjid al-Aqsa, Sulaiman alayhi salam made a special dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and asked for three things. First, he asked to be wise so that whatever decision he made between people who are arguing, Allah will be pleased. Second, he asked for a kingdom such that no one before or after him would have. Finally, he asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive the sins of any person who visits Masjid al-Aqsa and to make that person as pure as the day he or she was born. The rebuilding of the Masjid al-Aqsa continued. Sulaiman alayhi salam also built the Dome of the Rock, which is a beautiful building with a golden dome opposite Masjid al-Aqsa. As time went on, Sulaiman alayhi salam knew that his time in this world was coming to an end, and he worried that the masjid would remain unfinished after he passed away. One day, Sulaiman alayhi salam leaned on his walking stick, watching the workers rebuild Masjid al-Aqsa. While he was watching, Sulaiman alayhi salam passed away. But even though his soul was gone, Sulaiman alayhi salam remained upright, propped up on his walking stick. No one realized that Sulaiman alayhi salam was no longer with them, and thinking that he still watched them, the workers continued to build. Eventually, ants began to eat away at the bottom of Sulaiman alayhi salam's walking stick. The little ants ate and ate until the stick could not hold Sulaiman alayhi salam up anymore. When the stick fell out of his hand, the great Sulaiman alayhi salam fell to the ground. Everyone rushed to help Sulaiman alayhi salam, but when they reached him, they saw that he has passed away some time ago. In the meantime, work on Masjid al-Aqsa had continued without any interruption, and the rebuilding was complete. The story of Sulaiman alayhi salam's death shows us how, by ensuring that the building of Masjid al-Aqsa was completed, Allah answered Sulaiman alayhi salam's prayer to forgive the sins of those who visit the blessed masjid. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be pleased with him. Thank you for watching.